Hello there, Marty Ward here, your KISS procrastination goodbye expert. I got a story for you about mindset. Mindset is what is going to take you ultimately to that goal. What you focus on is what you get. So when we allow ourselves to go into doubt, uncertainty, never going to make it, having a chip on our shoulder, feeling sorry for ourselves, and when we focus on that, not going to happen. But when you focus on what you want, what you really desire, and keep your mind totally focused on that, that's when you can have it. So I have a story for you. It goes like this. In 2002, I lived in Annapolis, Maryland. I had moved from the Adirondack Mountains down to Annapolis, the sailing capital of the East Coast, because I wanted to sail. I've been a sailor my whole life. And I was racing 5 days a week. And in order to give back to my community, what I did is I joined the race committee at the Eastport Yacht Club. Well, I had the great fortune of being able to go down to Miami and to be an official on the race committee for the trials for the women's sailing team to see if they, which team was going to go to Greece in 2004. And it was such a privilege and a joy. And what made it even more fun is that one of the teams was from our yacht club, and one of my friends was on one of the teams. It was the boat's called a Yinling, and it's about 17 feet, and there are three women were aboard. And Liz was one of them. And so as I watched her on the course, it was great fun, except not so much fun by the third day when she had done really not very well at all. So it was very disappointing. And, you know, I figured out why. On my way to my car one night, I saw two team vans in the parking lot, and one was Liz's. And on the back of it, there was a bumper sticker that said, "On our way to Greece." And on the back of the van of the team that had won was a bumper sticker. You know what it said? In Greece, 2004. You see, you and I could be on our way to Greece. I mean, we might not do it this year, might not be next, but at some point we could say, yeah, we're on our way to Greece. Could be 5 years from now. And so the mindset between the winner and the loser was obvious. So being someone who always wants to be there for people, to encourage them, to give them the support they need, to give them the resources so they can be all of who they are and to get what they want in life, well, I had an idea. So when I got home to Annapolis, I invited Liz for breakfast. And after she sat down, I looked across the table at her and I said, "You know you're never going to make it, Liz, right?" And she said, "I know." And I explained about the bumpers, stickers. And she went, "Wow. Oh my Lord, you're right." And at that time, I was a yacht broker. I was a successful yacht broker in Annapolis, Maryland. And I wasn't a coach yet. But I was working with a coach. And my coach knew about prosperity, knew about mindset, knew about how to focus and how to be a winner, because she had helped me to be a winner when I was there. And so I recommended her to Liz. So Paula worked with Liz and her team for a year. And when I went back the next year, you know what happened? They were so far ahead that they didn't even have to race in the last race, because they'd already won the trials. Now there is a difference in mindset. Now this story I wish had a happier ending. Because you see, your mindset is something that you really need to nurture, need to stay with, stay on top of, and not give up. And to be there to support yourself when times get tough and there's struggles, and that you hang on to knowing who you are and to keep that laser focus on what you want. Because you see, what happened is when they got to Greece, They got second in the first race. Oh, my Lord! Celebration! The problem? It freaked them out. It freaked them out. Have you ever done that in your business where you have a really good month, a really good week, a really good day, and the next day, week, or month, you can't do it again? It's like you lost it because you got so excited, because you got so like, oh my Lord, and then you got scared. Well, that's what happened to them. And in the next race, they got 10th. Well, as you know, right? You have a great month and you have a bad month. Oh, and now you doubt yourself. You wonder if you can make it. You wonder if you can, if you really are that good. Well, maybe that was just a fluke. Well, maybe. And you doubt yourself and you stop listening to your intuition and you start to make poorer and poorer judgments. And that's what Liz and her team did. At one point, they were so discombobulated that they ran into one of the buoys that marked the course and came in 25th in one of the races. Overall, they came in 10th. Considering the 25th, that's pretty good. But all the years that they had all worked and all sailed in order to medal in the Olympics, stand there on the podium, and their mindset is what took it away. You see, because any athlete that gets to the Olympics can win, absolutely win. The only difference between winning and not placing is mindset. Because when you got it, you got it. I mean, picture, they've got stories usually when they do the Olympics, you know, they have the stories of each of the different people, and there's the picture of the little girl standing on some kind of box that she found in the garage with her handmade piece of ribbon with some kind of gold thing that she got by cutting out a piece of paper and painting it gold. And she's standing there in front of the mirror looking at herself saying, I'm an Olympian. I have a gold medal. Listening to the anthem playing, and she's 5. And at 25, she's standing on the podium, listening to the anthem playing. That's laser focus, belief, work, doing it. It's not about just wishful thinking and saying, oh, I'm going to have $10,000 at the end of the month. And then sitting in the lounge chair. It's you discovering about more of who you are, laser focusing your thought and keeping it on that target, on your ultimate goal, so that you can have fun, joy, play, excitement, exhilaration. Not about working too hard. No. That takes it away. That laser focus can easily be distracted by hurrying, by stressing, by anxiety. That laser focus, instead of being like this, goes, and now you got to start all over again. So mindset, focus, then take the steps to follow through. Now, if you need some help with this, click on the link below, give me a call. We'll talk about it and we'll teach you how to go step by step, how to keep the focus, what it takes, what do you need in order to do that.